On loss, we have completed up to question number 4. Today we'll start from question number 5. Okay, so let's start from question number 5 of exercise 5.1. Question number 5 is find the angle which is equal to its supplement. Yes, Sania, I'm very good. Hope all of you are also very good. Clear? Okay, now let's come to the point. Find the angle which is equal to its supplement. Okay, so let us consider the angle is x degree. Angle is x degree. So first find the supplement of this angle. Therefore, supplement of the angle is, so can you tell me what is the supplement of angle x? Yes, it is 180 minus x. Very good. 180 degree minus x. Now according to our problem, it is given that the angle is equal with its supplement angle. That means we can write, according to problem, the angle x which is equal to its supplement. Okay, now from here, this is a simple linear equation. We have to now solve it. That means x plus x is equal to 180. That means 2x is equal to 180. That means x is equal to 180 degree by 2, and 2 9s are 18, so that is 19. That means the value of x is equal to 19 degree. Value of x is equal to 90 degree. This is the answer. That means 90 degree is a supplement of itself. Okay, now tell me, have you understood? Do you have any problem here? Have you understood? If you have any problem regarding this question, you can tell me. Otherwise, we'll go to the next question. No problem. Very good. Okay. So now let's go to the next question. We just read the question number 6 once. Question number 6 is, in the given figure, angle 1 and angle 2 are supplementary angle, and the diagram is given here. Okay, so let's draw the diagram. Okay, so this is our angle 1 and this is our angle 2. Okay, now if one decreased, what change should take place in angle 2? If angle 1 decreased, so what changes took place in angle 2 so that both the angle still remain supplement? Can you tell me the answer? If you decrease the angle 1, so what changes take place in angle 2 such that angle 1 and angle 2 still be supplementary angle? Any idea from your side? Increased. Yes, they will. Okay. Now look, given that number 1 and angle 2 are supplementary angle. Now when you call two angles supplementary, when their sum is equal to 180 degree. Now look, if angle 1 decreased, means if I rotate this line anti-clockwise, then measurement of angle A angle 1 will be decreased. And at the same time, angle B will be increasing with the same rate as 1 decreased. So if angle 1 decreases, then angle 2 will be increased at the same rate, at the same rate, so that angle 1 and angle 2 still become supplement till become a supplement to each other. Okay, this is the answer. So have you understood? I hope you understood. Yes, so let's move to the next question. Next question is, can two angles be supplementary if both of them are acute, second is obtuse, and third is right angles? Okay. So if two angles are acute angle, so they will, this is question number 7, is it? Yes. So if two angles are acute angle, so the angles, whether the angles will be supplementary or not? Yes, no. Why is the reason? Look, when we call our angle supplementary, when the sum is equal to 90 degree. Now, if I consider two acute angle means the angle whose measurement is less than 90 degree. So, if I add two angle whose measurement is less than 90 degree, so their sum must be less than 180 degree. That means the angle will not be supplement to each other. Okay. Right here, as the sum of two acute angle is less than 180 degree, therefore they cannot be supplementary angle to each other. So they cannot be supplement angles. They cannot be supplementary angles to each other. Understood? Okay. Now the second question, if both the angles are obtuse angle, then what happened? Now obtuse angle means if the measurement of the angle is more than 90 degree, so we call the angle obtuse angle. Now if I consider two obtuse angle and if I add them, so look, the result will be more than 180 degree. So sum of two obtuse angle as not equal to 180 degree, so the two obtuse angle cannot be supplementary angle to each other. Right, the reason? As the sum of two obtuse angle is more than 180 degree, so they cannot be supplementary angle to each other. Okay, so right, so they cannot be supplementary
angle to each other.
Okay? Any problem? No problem. Okay. Now the last question is, if both the angles are right angles, so what happens if we sum up two right angles? So what will be the result? Obviously, the result will be 180 degrees, isn't it? Yes, 90 plus 90 plus 90, that is equal to 180. Means sum of two right angles is equal to 180 degrees. That means two right angles are supplementary angle to each other. So question number 3 is as the sum of two right angles is equal to 180 degrees. That means two right angles are supplementary angle to each other. Okay, now this question has completed. Now, have any problem? No. Okay, so now let's move to the next question. Question number 8. An angle is greater than 45, its complementary angle is less than 45, greater than 45, or equal to 45. I will not do it. You tell me what will be the result. If an angle is 45 degrees, so whether its complementary angle is greater than 45, less than 45, or equal to 45, Ayantik Samant is saying they will be equal to 45. And Sania is saying that less than 45 degrees. Okay, let's see. Yes, less than 50. Yeah, obviously they will, the supplementary angle will be less than 45 degrees. I think you have done a little mistake here. For example, if I consider an angle which is greater than 45 degrees. Okay, so let us consider the angle as suppose 50 degrees, which is obviously greater than 45 degrees. Now find the complementary angle of 50 degrees. So complementary angle of 50 degrees is 90 minus 50 degrees, which is equal to 40 degrees. Now look, this result must be less than 45 degrees. That means if one angle is greater than 45 degrees, so its complementary angle must be less than 45 degrees. Okay, so right, if an angle is greater than 45 degrees, its complementary angle is less than 45 degrees. If an angle is greater than 45 degrees, its complementary angle will be less than 45 degrees. Less than 45 degrees. Okay, now let's move to the next question. Question number 9. In the adjoining figure, okay, so let's draw the diagram. Two line AB and CD intersecting each other at the point O. This is our AB line. And there's another line, CD. They are intersecting each other at the point O, and there is another line from the point O as OE. Okay, and the name of the angles are given as the name of the angle are given as this is angle 1, this angle is angle 2, this angle is angle 3, this is fourth angle, and this is the fifth angle. I have colored it by different color such that you can understood very properly. Now first question is 1 and 2 are adjacent angle? Angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. Angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. Okay, first tell me the reason, answer. Is angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2? Yes, obviously yes. Okay, can you tell me why angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent angle? Why angle 1? Yes. So look, I told you in my previous class that if two angles satisfy three conditions, then the angles will be adjacent angle. And what are the conditions, sir? Number 1, they must share a common vertex. Number 2, they share a common side. And number 3, the non-common side lying on the different side of the common side. On either side of the common side. Okay, let's see whether angle 1 and angle 2 satisfied these three conditions or not. So number 1, look, O is the vertex of angle 1, also O is the vertex of angle 2. That means O is a common vertex. Okay. Number 2, look, they have a common side also, OC. OC is the side of first angle, and also OC is the side of the second angle. That means this side OC is a common side. And number 3, the non-common sides. What are the non-common sides? This is the common side. So one non-common side is OA. And one non-common side is OE. Now look, OA and OE are lying on the different side. One is lying on that side and another line OE is lying this side. So third condition is OA and OE lie on either side of OC. Now under these three conditions, we can say that angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. Angle 1 is adjacent angle to angle 2. Okay? So first question is yes. Now have you understood? Okay, so yes, I know that. Okay, have you understood? Sir, only 7 students are doing class. Yes, I can see the number of students attending my class. This is their problem. I don't know why they are not attending the class. In the previous class, I have seen a lot of students attending the class. I don't know what happened today. Okay, so now next question. Angle AOC. So find out the angle. Angle AOC means angle 1. And angle AOE. Okay, so let's see whether these two angles are adjacent angle or not. One angle is angle AOC and angle AOE. Now tell me whether the angles are adjacent angle or not. Angle AOC and angle AOE. AOC and AOE. Yes, Ayantik Samanti is saying that no, they are not adjacent angle. Ayantik, can it, okay, Saina also saying they are not adjacent angle. Can you tell me the reason, which condition is not satisfied here? That's why angles are not adjacent angle. Which condition out of the three condition is not satisfied? Which one? Okay, let's discuss. So first condition, we'll check whether they have a common vertex or not. Okay, so what is the vertex of angle AOC? Obviously. And what is the vertex of angle AOE? That is also. Means O is a common vertex. Number two, let us find out the if they have a common side or not. Ayantik saying they not common side. Okay, let's see they have a common side or not. Now look at the angle AOC. What are the side of angle AOC? One is OA and one is OC. Okay, now find out the sides of angle AOE. What are the sides? One is AO and one is OE. Now look, OA is a common side to angle AOC and AOE. That means AO is the common side. Common side. My second condition is also satisfied. So they have a common side. As Ayantik said, they don't sharing any common side. So it is not true. They sharing a common side. That is OA. And now we'll look at the third condition. Third condition is this is the common side. And what are the non-common side? One is OC and one is OE. Now look, both the non-common sides are lying on the same side of the common side. Okay, that means non-common sides are not lying on the different side. Okay, so non-common side, non-common side are on the same side means condition number 3 is not satisfied. That means the angles AOC and angles AOE are not adjacent angle. Okay, angle AOC and angle AOE are not adjacent angle. Have you understood, Ayantik? What mistake have you done? Okay, now next question. Do angles COE? Okay, so let's solve the next question. Angle COE angle COE and angle EOD. Angle COE and angle EOD. Check whether the angles are adjacent angle or not. Angle COE and angle angle DOA. Okay, so let's see. Angle COE means C O E, number 2 angle, and angle EOD means this total angle. So whether the angles are adjacent angle or not. Okay, yes, they are adjacent angle. Why? O is the common side, first condition satisfied. Okay, they have a common side as OE. So as this is the common side and non-common sides are lying on the different side, on the either side, that means the angles are supplementary angle to each other. Okay, so question number 3 is also done. Oh, actually we have to prove that this is a linear pair of nerve. Obviously they are adjacent angle and non-common sides are lying on a straight line. Non-common sides are lying on a straight line. That means angle COE and angle EOD are linear pair of angles. Yes? Okay. So today up to these questions. In next class we'll start from question number 4, 9. Yes, time's up, I know. So today up to this much. Okay, so bye bye.